I feel like I'm in the Bridge to Terabithia, if I'm real with you right now. I
have
just...
you seen who's in the have you seen who's in the chat, mate?
That's why I got distracted, Wilbur. That's why I was like, why? Did you say sorry? Did we have a conversation going on?
How's it going, man? He thinks it's just me. Nikki, can you say hi so it doesn't look like I'm just talking to his girl, please?
Hi, Shalat.
Shalat, do you want to join the VC?
Thank you for 5 gifted subs, Fusion.
He declined the call.
Thank you for 5 gifted subs. What the fuck? Thank you for 5 gifted subs.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Hey.
Hi.
Hey, Joe Shalat.
Hey, Mix, who are you in the call with right now? Who's here in the call?
Just some friends of mine.
Just some friends of yours, okay.
Yeah. And their names are Nikki and Wilbur. Have you ever met them before?
I think I might have heard of them.
Oh, I actually have.
Nice to meet you.
Maybe just once, you know?
So, how are you? Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Wilbur Soot.
I think I've seen you around on Twitter. You're quite a big name on the Twitter scene, aren't you?
Yeah, a couple hundred thousand followers.
Yeah. Oh, really? Wow. Yeah.
Nothing too big.
I mean, I'm sure you tweet quite a lot, don't you? Probably to get that amount.
Like every day.
Yeah, dude. Proud of you.
Just not that it matters or anything, but did you invite Schlatt just to flirt with him, Wilbur? Just asking.
That's such an old meme now, Mings. Please get off it, right?
I had a Hot Pocket today.
Did you? Well, actually, it is one of those. I've never actually had one.
It's like bread, but there's like meat and cheese in the middle.
That sounds like
and you put it in the microwave, and then you just kind of eat it once it comes out.
So is it like just if you took a pizza and like folded it over?
Yeah, kind of, but it's like completely encased in the bread.
Oh, I see. Is it like Italian or?
Oh no, it's
why are you fucking talking like that? Why are you fucking making your voices lower and raspier as you're talking about fucking Hot Pocket?
I mean, you just put it in there for a couple
minutely
minutes
asking a question.
No, you're it's not just, your voices has all changed and, in the time of this conversation. There has been a change in the tone of your voices.
Delicious savory treat.
What's the kind of what sort of price and what we saw pricing are we looking at for Hot Pockets? Right?
Oh, I mean it's just a couple dollars. You just pull it out of the freezer.
You're saying at the same tone.
Really? Well, the freezer. Oh, so you have to defrost them, or do you just pop them in there? Do you defrost them, or do you just pop them straight
in
the
microwave when you put it in for like 2 minutes, and then you've got a delicious salty treat.
Yeah. Oh, salty.
Stop.
Oh yeah. Well, you get the one with the pretzel bread, then you've got some salt around the outside, and you can.
Okay.
Just like put it in your mouth and taste the salt.
Mm. Yeah.
I feel ill.
And
we don't have those in the UK. We don't have
there's
salt.
Some cheese and some
nothing,
some
Nikki.
Meat in there.
You're not gonna help me with these two.
I don't know.
Is there different flavors?
But I like the pretzel one the most, definitely.
That's the one you're just telling me. Yeah.
The pretzel bread. Yeah.
Right.
So you just eat that, and you got a good like 15, 16 bites before you're at the end.
Oh, right. Oh, so they're quite big. Like,
did you guys know that if you have Amazon Prime, you can just free Twitch Prime sub?
You get two in the
box. Yeah, it's
like
free money every month.
Particularly hungry, you could pop both in the microwave. But
stop! It's getting worse! I didn't know it could get worse, but it's getting worse. The tone is getting worse.
Do you ever get the issue? Do you ever get the issue where, like, if you put two of them in the microwave and the microwave table starts to turn, they get, like, caught on the edges of the microwave because you've...
Oh, yeah, they definitely do. They definitely do get caught sometimes, but the biggest problem if you're putting two in at the same time is that it won't cook them through, so you'll have center. And I mean, that's
why
when you're talking about Hot Pockets, you really want to avoid that.
How are you still talking about Hot Pockets? You haven't even changed food.
Right? Do you have to put them in for longer if you got two of them, or does it kind of like even out across both?
Usually, what
Stop!
I would do is. And put the first one in, and then I'd eat it, and then when I'm you know, like 75-85% complete with the first hot pocket, I'd pop the second one in. And I cook that for another 2 minutes, like, because if you put them both in at the same time, they're going to get...
The tone's getting worse! It's lore! It's fucking... It's dead-ass lore! I had to listen for a good 3 seconds.
I mean, the second one's going to be cold, and then it's just not worth eating, you know? You're going to have to put it in the microwave for a second.
You've got a battle plan. You've got a battle plan for this. I actually really appreciate that in culinary expertise.
I put a lot of thought into it.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it goes to show, and it's not being ignored.
Ew! Who did that? I hate you both so much. Nikki.
My gamer subs.
Nikki, help me.
You know, you get a water bottle, you fill it up with water, put two, three scoops of gamer subs in there, shake it up around, and you just go to town.
I don't know about that one. I think I want to sign a contract before I start talking about this one.
Oh. Yeah, that's fair. I think that's fair.
Yeah, no worries. So how'd you meet Minx then?
Anyway.
Well, let's talk about Hot Pockets for a bit more. So, my least favorite flavor has got to be the ham and cheese one.
Oh, that does sound awful, actually.
Yeah, well, I mean, the problem I have with it is that the ham is just not very tasty.
Oh, the ham's
the cheese, yeah, well, I mean, the bread is kind of porous, and once you put it in the microwave for a while, the cheese starts to seep out, and so once you pull it out of the microwave, you're left with just a cheesy mess. It's just soppy, disgusting.
Oh, it's really like, not the best. Yeah, I get it. You could probably, because also you've cooked it from frozen, so haven't given it.
Yeah, of course. And the best drink by far, I've said this, I mean, I'll say this again and again, time and time again, Wilbur, but the best one is the pretzel bread hot pocket.
Right. I'm gonna say something.
And the meat in the middle.
Can it not be about Hot Pockets, Wilbur?
No, it is about Hot Pockets. So it's the I'm getting the whole like Hawaiian vibe when you say the ham and cheese, right? I'm gonna say a bit of a dreadful question because I can't seem to imagine this. But would it be possible to have a pineapple-based Hot Pocket?
Oh, you know, I wouldn't be interested if there was. So I couldn't really tell you. I mean, the Publix near me are mostly just ham and cheese and the pretzel bread one. So it's either it's one or the other. You know, it's hot and it's cold, and so I take the one that I enjoy the most. So.
Well, that's fair enough. I mean, yeah, especially during a quarantine like this, you gotta take what you can get. You know,
you really do. And I mean, the store says, you know, all the employees go up to me and they're like, "Shalat, I mean,
stop! Why am I getting into this conversation? Stop for a minute. Cut me off. I don't like this. Stop with the Hot Pocket."
They go up to me while I'm in the freezer aisle, and they say, "Shlet, you know, it's limit 2 per Hot Pocket box."
Oh no.
And I look at them in the eyes and I say, "Hey, listen, buddy, you make $9 an hour. If you come to the restaurant and stop me from getting these Hot Pockets, I'm just going to breathe on you."
Well, I mean, that would send anyone away, I expect.
And I mean, that would send anybody away. You know, no one who makes that little amount of money is going to talk to me like he's above me. I'm the big man? Exactly.
Yeah. And it's like new money, it's all cash. They were probably killed to be able to afford Hot Pockets.
And so I just take as many Hot Pockets as I like, and I pay for it with my business MasterCard, and I walk away and pop it in the microwave for 2 minutes, and then I'm left with a salty outside and savory inside.
And here's the thing, and then after you've eaten them as a power play, you go straight back. You go straight back to the Publix, and you go straight back and you grab another more than two. You grab another 4 or 5.
They've restocked it. And it's at this point where the employees start to get a little antsy and you know, their tone shifts. But I always just, I stick to my guns and I say, "Listen, buddy, I'm going to breathe on you if you come any closer to me."
Why do they turn?
Do they not? Do they want a part of that? Are they trying to? Do they push you on that?
No, they're not trying to get my breath on them. I mean, what if I have Rona? You know, I mean, it's too big of a chance. I mean, what if they're not able to come in for their $9 an hour work? I mean, it would be pure chaos.
Just and all that over a Hot Pocket, it's not worth it. You know, maybe it's worth to get breathed on for $9 an hour if you're like saving someone's life or something. But over a Hot Pocket, I just
But I mean, these people are not vital workers, right? I mean, they're expendable, and so you know, even though I'd say, you know, hey, maybe it wouldn't be a big deal if these guys got Corona, at the same time, I'm just trying to get my Hot Pockets, and I'm not trying to spread it.
It's a job anyone can do. Even someone who's got the disease, let's be quite honest with you, because at the end of the day, you can just shove it. You could just have gloves and a mask, you know, it's fully avoidable. And then also the Hot Pockets, I imagine, are sealed, so it's not an issue of contamination on the food. Okay.
You got the cardboard box that the Hot Pockets come
in. Are they coming in a box? That's a new development I really wasn't expecting.
And get this, buddy. Every Hot Pocket individually wrapped. I used to have a friend who'd stick it in the microwave with the plastic around it, and it'd come out soggy.
Dangerous.
Just disgusting mess.
They individually wrap each one. See, now I can imagine that increases waste, but it really increases preservation quality.
It really increases the preservation quality of the product. I couldn't have said it better myself, Wilbur. I mean, you take one of these out, comes with a nice cardboard.
Did you guys know that if you have Amazon Prime, you get a free Twitch Prime sub? What?
That Prime right there.
The branding. That's really smart marketing technique, because then other companies will want to use that phrase.
And I mean, I'm sure they can't, because Hot Pockets probably trademarked it to a certain extent, so no one else can call it a crisping sleeve.
The phrase crisping sleeve is going to be used colloquially to speak to about any catalyst, you know, any sort of like cooking catalyst. So people are going to start using that as the word, similar to a verb, you know. What's going to happen about that is then that people are going to start using that, and then companies are going to start having to either change the title or use it as well and pay the licensing fee. So really, it's a win-win for Mr. Hot.
The second most profitable business side of the Hot Pockets business franchise is the licensing of the term.
Voice gotten lower, Schlock?
I find that incredible. Like,
it's absolutely incredible. And I mean, I walk into that Publix every day.
Did you guys know that if you have Amazon Prime, you get a free Twitch Prime sub? What? Yeah, it's like a free, it's like free money every month.
Love you, Minx.
And I walk out. I mean, usually they charge you. They charge you for plastic bags. They don't charge me.
No.
Why? Hey, buddy, if you don't give me that bag for free, I'm going to start breathing on you.
Do you have Do you have self-service checkouts in the United States?
Oh yeah, we do.
Yeah,
to assert my dominance, so I go the worker that gets paid $9 an hour.
Mm-hmm. I think preferably the way to really assert your dominance if you're using the self-service, I find, is when you go up there and you purposefully take a bag. You may even want to double bag it. I don't know I like that. I like that. But basically, right. You take the bag, you maybe want to double back it, right? There's always that one security guard who's like,
it'd be so much better if you guys had cameras so we could see you leaning into your mice, and it would be way less impactful.
Stuff into the bag, and then you just click that extra bag button.
Exactly. That's exactly what I've thought about, but I mean, at the same time, Wilbur, there's something so much more potent about asserting your dominance in front of a real person rather than doing it in front of
it's the rush that you might get caught. That's the bit that does it for me. That's what gets my rocks.
I don't like the word potent.
I respect it.
So what do you guys think of furry porn?
When you get the Hot Pockets home,
I mean, I put it in the freezer, and then typically I'm feeling rather hungry as I get home from the Publix.
Yeah.
So I'll take one out and you know, I'll unwrap it and I'll slip it in the crispies.
Wait, why is it embarrassing?
Is there like a sitting time? Like, do you have to like leave it out to sit before you can chow down?
Yeah. So you've never seen Beasters, Nikki?
For an extra minute.
I don't know what that is. I'm really scared. Honestly,
that just sounds like a delaying tactic to stop you getting your Hot Pockets.
Listen, buddy. A lot of people complain about the temperature of the hot.
How the fuck are you two still talking about Hot Pockets? I hear the fucking word come into it again.
No, I know what you mean, man. So, I get you. So
how long has it been?
Skip the sitting period and you just go straight into chowing down on that boiling hot pocket.
Yeah, well, I'm not really in the business of burning my mouth because it's just, you know, how am I going to enjoy the rest of the
party? Is this what ecstasy feels like? I don't do hard drugs, but if you like some hard drug, this is the equivalent of it.
And a couple bites in, I am now at the point where I can start unwrapping the crisping sleeve. There's two sections to the crisping sleeve. There's a longer version and a shorter version, so you tear the first part off of the crisping sleeve, and now you're left with a slightly smaller, stouter crisping sleeve that exposes more of the warm hot.
Oh, that is what I like to hear. That is good. So, and it's almost so like peeling back a banana, almost.
Ew, you don't even sound like yourselves anymore.
That's good, that's good. Exactly. So,
it's almost like disrobing the hot pocket, which is so potent. And so then you're left with more of the hot pocket to chow down on, and so that's what I'll usually do.
This is relying that the crisping sleeve is not getting soggy through the defrosting process. The
crisping sleeve never gets soggy. It never gets soggy. I mean, at least if you have the pretzel bread hot pocket, I never have that problem. Yeah.
Oh, okay, so with the cheese one.
What's great about it is that the crisping sleeve allows the hot pocket to stand upwards. And so that means gravity. Well, that means gravity. And listen to me here.
Yeah.
That means gravity affects the meat. The cheese inside the hot pocket.
Sorry.
Whoever in chat said this hot pocket thing should be a podcast, I need you to know that you don't deserve to go anywhere in life.
So you almost lost the first.
Not after that one.
And this means the hot pocket gets more and more delicious as you move down.
How the fuck are you still talking about hot pockets?
That's really good.
Stop
interrupting them, FFS.
The both of you has caused my chat to donate me to give out to me for stop interrupting me.
Right.
They're not even stopping.
My satisfaction tends to decrease. Almost, I don't know what it is. It's almost a boredom, like an ennui starts to increase as I get through the meal. But what you're saying is by erecting the hot pocket, what we can do here is we can actually lower the boredom and create a sort of a pool of ecstasy at the bottom.
Some might call it exponentially increasing pleasure as you go down the hot pocket. And I mean, let me tell you, Wilbert, the last two bites of this thing are absolutely orgasmic. I mean, they really are. They really are. I wish I could share it with you, but you know, you're all the way over there, and I'm all the way over here, and so
one day. Sometime
we should, of course. All right, I'll see you later, Wilbur. Goodbye. Right.
Bye bye.
I hate you both so much. I cannot believe you talked about how I don't even know how many minutes passed.
I think it was like 20 minutes or something.
Nothing, Wilbur. You've got nothing after that. You're all out.
I'm still reeling back a little bit. What were you saying about subs, though? You were saying something about General Sam and needing subs.
You know what?
Like about 20 minutes ago, you were saying something. You couldn't remember something about General Sam and Twitch.
Nah, you know what? I'm good. Yeah. I got Wilbur.
This should cover
Nikki,
a box of Hot Pockets minks.
I think that should cover my entire stay in America.